What's that? It does. Blackberry. Peach. Cinnamon.
Pump
what? Is that like basic moonshine? I don't know, but this place is full of different kinds of stuff. All activities are recorded. Coffee flavored moonshine makes a lot of sense. Buying something and then actually able to make it right here.
Yeah, I think they get to keep the aprons and they give them a little sheet for whatever they make. There's a whole group of kids that just got finished, and that guy on the right in that picture, whoever he's famous for, whatever winning something, is in there like signing autographs.
Oh, that's really cool.
And they do blacksmithing lessons. So your sister can send Nico here.
So we're in Pigeon Forge, Tennessee, and apparently Leslie says this place has the best apple butter ever. And as we pull in here.
Ooh, and I see a winery.
Look at that.
Can you make wine with apples?
I don't know.
Can we go in there too? Just
sure.
Kind of look in the middle.
Okay.
Let's check it out. Hard cider.
Ooh, see, now we're talking.
You like hard cider?
I love hard cider. If it's good. I mean, I don't like that crappy stuff everybody always
Let's
drinks.
Let's start backwards.
Okay. What's it called?
Bye-bye?
No, like what's the cheap apple cider everybody always drinks? You know they're not gonna have vegan ice cream, right? Maybe they will.
Apple-based
ones. Are you guys looking to summit?
Yeah. Thank you. Good. Do you want to say it? Tart start, but a sweet finish.
That's weird. It's like drinking grape juice or something. That could be dangerous.
Really?
Yes. It doesn't taste like alcohol at all. Something different. I want to try one of the drier ones, though. Sure.
I'm going to go for the apple.
Oh, because some of these are just regular wines.
Yep.
I got you. No, I'm really curious about this apple undertone part of this.
100% apples aged in American oak. It resembles a Chardonnay in flavor, but it is all apple.
Hmm. Yeah, I like it drier than sweeter. That apple raspberry literally tasted like juice.
Really?
Mm-hmm. I mean, it wasn't bad, and it was good. She's right, it had tart. It wasn't so sweet. But you would get in trouble drinking that, for sure.
Would you drink any of it, like, on a regular basis?
I would drink that. Last one I had, that white.
Really?
And probably this. And this is way sweeter than I would normally like, but it's really good.
Really?
Really dangerous, I think.
I just don't care about sweet wine enough to care about it. But people that like sweet wine probably really dig it home.
Well, these are, that's not even considered.
I know, I'm just saying.
I think you would like, you would have liked that one.
Really?
I like that better than the raspberry, I think.
I want the hard cider, please. We
yeah,
need to
yeah.
go look at the hard
okay.
cider house.
Oh, that is the wine I just had, actually.
All right, you get two free samples.
Okay.
You want to start off with a traditional South cider?
Yes.
Okay. So this is South cider. It's a traditional apple. 6.5% alcohol. We make everything up there at the winery.
Oh. That's why that room is so big.
Oh, okay.
It's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. It's really... clean is the wrong, is almost the only word I could think of.
That's a good description of it. It's crisp.
Mm-hmm. It literally is like a cold, fresh apple.
Has that actually got more hop to it? Like more beery,
it's like
beer-ish?
It's more of a, well, it's more hoppy. It's like an IPA cider.
I'll try that. I'm an IPA junkie. So.
Okay, yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah, it's like just a hoppy, there's four different hops in there with the cider.
We're going to go over there first and come back.
You don't want to carry it?
Uh-oh. But I'm going to come back and get a bottle of that.
Yeah, we parked right here.
That's really good.
Awesome.
Yeah, we're parked up.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Yeah, we'll be back in a few minutes. So we got four different kinds of cider because the cider is really good. Apple cider, I would not say that normally, but like hoppy cider and then a ginger and then regular apple is really good. And then what are these? Cinnamon apple chips. Those can go in the front. Spicy sweet pickles. Apple butter, the whole reason we came here. So I think we're gonna go find a scenic, beautiful place to park and make a sandwich. And I wanna see if this stuff is any good. I bet it's awesome. What do you wanna try first? We have cool pickles to try.
Oh yeah.
Apple barn pickles. That was a little anticlimactic.
Oh, I hear them crunching.
Mm-hmm. The apple butter is amazing. That's all I'm gonna say. Yeah, I mean this is.
I'm already nervous.
This is amazing. I love this stuff.
Not made for ski lifts.
No? What's weird is we go down first.
Yeah.
We're going way up there. It is a lot of people. This is a really cool thing. I think people should come here and try.
The price is very affordable for what this is, I think.
I thought, yeah, at the time of this video, $20 or whatever,
23. 23 day of, you can buy it ahead of time.
Yeah, if you bought it ahead of time online.
19.
It'd be 19 something, which is what we should have did. I thought about it yesterday and I just didn't.
I think it's more than 2 days out. So I don't think
is it?
Do it that last minute, yeah.
We're going over a street. This is steep, dude. Wicked steep. So like, if I start wiggling or anything? No. Have you ever been on a ski lift before?
I don't think so. The one at the San Diego Zoo might be the only thing like this I've ever done. That basket thing we did,
that was my
first time ever doing something like that.
But that was like a full gondola that you were inside of.
Yeah. So the correct answer would be no.
Yeah, there were some people coming down and I heard them say, "Hey, I think those people are YouTubers." So I think if you have a camera, with a fuzzy thing on top.
Yeah, yeah.
You're automatically a YouTuber. That's what you do.
Yeah.
Automatically. Are we gonna get some kind of like roller coaster gimmicky picture that
Should we pose silly
for? Yeah, let's pose.
Prepare to unload. Raise the bar.
Go to my right? Cool, thanks, man.
Go ahead, off your right.
Incident free.
So you can't even see it because it's so steep. So like we couldn't get the steep perspective before.
You can't even see the bottom from the top. Yeah. It's so steep.
But that's the building. So like that's crazy.
Way down there. The other thing is I want to point your attention to. We look over at the bridge. See the cables? That thing sways back and forth a lot.
Oh, because they're not tight.
It's like.
I want to go right here.
All ready?
I'm not ready.
No? You don't like that little swaying bouncy motion?
No, not really.
Oh. It moves a little more than you think.
Yeah. Water stance walk. You have to walk like a corn cob in your butt or something.
I'm leaving that in. Yeah, it moves around a lot.
Yeah, this thing is moving a lot. What is it, like 100 and something feet in the middle? 100 and...
Alright. It's just like walking on a trampoline. Kind of crazy, huh? Yeah. I really like this whole trip we just took. The thing that messes with your head is the when you look at another one, like look at somebody else's chairlift and they're swaying one way and you're swaying the other, that kind of messes with your head a little bit.
I don't think we're going fast enough to be swaying.
I mean, I could do it.
No.
Okay.
That's why they don't all the way connect. So there is like a, oh, I can't look up. I would get really dizzy then. But like, it's like a grip, like it doesn't touch. It's not like.
Yeah, it's like a C clamp. That kind of grips almost all the way around.
Right.
It's not gonna come off. I don't know if there's some sort of FAA of chairlifts, but I'm sure that they've inspected it. Just start yelling, does this feel tight enough to you? Is that supposed to wiggle?
Bridge, and he was telling that couple that a lot of, so like that thing we saw that was abandoned,
yes,
like all this stuff that looks run down and didn't rebuild, they weren't to code, like when they went to rebuild, like stuff was grandfathered in, and then when you have to rebuild it wasn't to code and like people went out of business.
Wow. Yeah, so here we are thinking this is some old like ancient rundown building, but it's actually only a couple. It's only been gone a couple of years because of this fire. Mm-hmm. What's amazing to me is how much it has grown back, because this place is beautiful. One of the things I was thinking about all this thing today, I wonder how many people we saw that were like literally like changed because they went across a thing and now they like addressed like some kind of fear that they had before, that now they could handle something or other. Because this is pretty tall and bouncy, that I can see why people couldn't handle it. If they, it doesn't bother me, but I'm into this, so